Fallout 4 is a game rated M by the ESRB.
So, seems you know how to hold your own. I'd had my doubts when we first hit the road.
Doubts?
Oh yeah? What kind of doubts?
You kidding me? You look like you'd fallen out of the vault that day. I thought I'd see you picking your teeth out of the gutter by sunup. It's just real rare these days. Find someone who's not willing to take things the way they're handed to them. Too many good folks not willing to get their hands dirty. And too many assholes taking advantage of it. Look at what happened to Diamond City. Before McDonough took over, it was a half-decent place to live. A little stricter than I usually go for, but not terrible. I thought he and I had a pretty happy childhood. But then he decides he's gonna try and get elected with his anti-ghoul crusade. Mankind for McDonough. Before you know it, you got families with kids lining up to drag folks they call neighbor out of their homes and throw them to the ruins.
You and McDonough knew each other as kids?
Oh yeah. Guy's my brother. Grew up together in a little shack on the waterfront. Guy was the standard big brother. Entitled. Punchy. Liked to shove rotten potatoes down my shirt and slap my back. But I never thought he'd be capable of something like what they did to those ghouls.
Wow. That's crazy. I had no idea that they were related.
Why did McDonough campaign against the ghouls?
Because he thought he could win. There'd always been a pretty clear divide between the folks living in the stands and those down on the field. I'm not convinced they didn't do it just to improve their view. I remember storming into his office above the stands after the inauguration speech. He was just standing there, staring out the window, watching as the city turned on the ghouls. He didn't even look at me. Just said, "I did it, John. It's finally mine." Should have killed him right there, but I don't think it would have changed anything. Instead, I pleaded with him, begged him to call it off. He said he couldn't. He had nothing against the ghouls. He was just carrying out the will of the people. And he couldn't betray the voters. And then he smiled. That hideous fucking mile-long smile. He never smiled like that when we were kids. I didn't even recognize him.
What do you mean you didn't recognize him?
I don't know. Just didn't seem like the guy I grew up with. When I'd first heard the rumors, he'd been swapped for a synth. Thinking back on that night, I thought it made a lot of sense. But now, I don't know. I don't think I buy it. I've seen him since then, and there's no way they copied him that perfectly. Even got his tight-ass walk. But at the time, I just needed to get the hell away from him. Him and that whole damn city.
He murdered those ghouls.
Him and that whole damn city. I still wasn't a ghoul at this point, so I didn't have to leave. But I couldn't bring myself to stay in that cesspool after that. I'd been sneaking off the good neighbor for years to get decent chems, so I knew the safe routes. I managed to track down a couple of the families, lead them there, but most couldn't get used to the good neighbor lifestyle. I brought them food for a couple of weeks, but after a while, they just disappeared. Folks in Diamond City signed their death warrants, and all the good people were willing to just sit by and watch. I felt like I was the only one who saw how screwed up things truly were. Who couldn't just pretend things were fine. Still feel that way. Or, I did. Until I met you. I know I run my mouth, but having someone who sees the world for what it is, and is willing to do something about it, it's meant a lot to me. I feel damn lucky to have you as a friend.
It was then that Grit Jones threw that stoic smirk on his face, and those patrolman sunglasses, looked at his good buddy, Hancock, with a different feeling in his heart. A feeling full of rib cages and hard hats. I'm getting there, Hancock! Jeez!
And that's what we are? Friends?
Well, now that you mention it, I have been having slightly more impure thoughts than usual. Maybe we'll get to, act on those. But I guess we should probably head out, huh? After you.
Hello, and welcome back to more Stephen Plays Fallout 4. Did not expect that it would start with that. Soon as I booted up the game, Hancock really wanted to chat. Let me first apologize, because you are getting this on Monday, and generally you get Fallout on Sunday, and Wednesdays, of course. That is actually not my fault. There are occasions where the schedule is my fault. This is one where Bethesda broke their own game. Oh my god, they released a patch that affected a very specific subset of people. It affected Xbox One players who have season passes. And guess what? That's me. Apparently what it did is it caused the Vault-Tec Workshop DLC to... like, it didn't detect that it was there. And whenever I went to load the game, it was like, hey, we're gonna just act as if this thing's not here. Do you want to load it anyway? And honestly, that scared me. The good news was that I hadn't used the Vault-Tec Workshop yet, but I was still scared to actually load it. And Bethesda had said on Twitter that it was gonna be fixed within a day, so I was like, you know what? We'll just move things around. So I did post it on Twitter. So if you were completely in the dark, please at least, you don't have to follow me on Twitter, although I would recommend it. But, you know, just go to Twitter anytime something seems weird, because that will probably solve that that question. All right. Now, when we last left off, we were down here with Deacon and Hancock. We've just gotten into this crazy, crazy place that's all underneath a Slocum Joe's. And, I'm really interested, or is it Slocum?
That's seen some fun in its day.
Is it Slocum Joe's or Slocum's Joe? I think it's Slocum's Joe. Anyway, there's a lot of interesting stuff around here, and we are not done yet. We are still on this first railroad mission, which is what we're going to continue doing.
Is someone present?
And it looks like there's some guys around to kill. I don't know why we need that. I don't know what material is in that teddy bear, but whatever. I guess somewhere up there in the corner is where the guys are? Is this a dead end? It is, but there may be some stuff. There we go, here's some stuff. Shotgun shells. And more sunglasses, which we already have, I feel, plenty of. From reading your comments, it sounds like Deacon actually, never takes off his sunglasses. Like, he's just always keeping them on. And apparently he continues to change outfits. Was he even wearing this before? I feel like he changed. I don't know. He looks a little different. Let's keep wandering around here and see what we can see. Did I check you already? I did. Or you just never had anything to begin with. Let's go upstairs. See what we can find. There was a synth upstairs. Not exactly sure where. But we'll probably run into that. Okay, we got a central terminal. As I slowly go around this chair here. Wasteland. Likeness 2.
I'm in.
Okay, let's see here. DEFCON status. Let's see. Anchorage all clear. Come back, blah, blah, blah. USFA says eyes on squadron airplanes. High altitude of running straight, blah, 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 blah. Confirms bird in air. Doesn't mean a whole lot to me. Pennsylvania, New York, confirmed strike. So we got some bomb strikes. DEFCON archive database corrupt. All right. Well, I hacked that and got the experience, but there wasn't anything of particular interest in there. U.S. covert operations manual.
Hell yeah.
More difficult to detect while sneaking, which is honestly one of my favorite magazines to get. So I'm pretty happy with that. Let's see, we also have got another terminal and a door. Sure, I'm hacking all these terminals, because I've undergone lots of training. Son of a gun.
Sweet.
Alright, optical tripwire control. Laser sec systems, optical intrusion. Deactivate. Okay, so apparently there's tripwires, which I can turn off. Which seems like...
sensor reading detected.
Seems like the correct thing. Alright, we're about to have a little showdown here.
Overactive sensors, nothing more.
You just say the word if you want to take a little chem break.
Oh yeah, Hancock. See, my last companion was all about them chems, but then also she had a rough life and needed to not have the chems, so I stopped taking the chems. I would take some chems right now. I don't have any. I can drink this dirty water if you're into that. But I don't think that's gonna do the same thing. Hey man, you let me know. Do you have any drugs?
No. Psst. Do you look like you could use a little?
Thanks. Drugs. Drugs. All right, drugs. Drugs. Grit drugs. Grit drugs. Grit drugs. Grit's not so good when he's on drugs. Oh, how many more are there? We good? Good, we're good! And I deactivated— Oh my god! The piss was that? Sounded like a, maybe a bottle cap mine. Yeah, really? Now's not a good time. Alright, you need to hold on to all of this stuff. Cause this is holding me down. I'm just trading you for the drugs. I appreciate the drugs so much. Please hold all of my desk fans. So I can take more desk fans. Is there anything of value or interest in here? Bobby pin box? No crap on the floor, but nothing particularly interesting. Nothing down there? This place might end up being a little bigger than I think it is.
Now I understand. You are hiding because you fear death.
There's a synth leader. Okay.
Lower limb actuator damaged.
Doesn't look like there's anyone this way.
Gone. Excellent.
Okay, so at least we found a safe area for now. With boxes full of blood sacks.
You know what any of this stuff is for?
Let's see, there's a terminal here. Let's see. I fear death. No, I don't. Because I'm gonna win in a flash. Jeez, I keep coming up short.
I'm through.
Oh, that worked. Security door control. Open the doors. Perfect. Okay, I don't know what I opened, but we'll go check it out here in a sec. Anything else of interest? The moon monkey can stay. I think I have enough moon monkeys. These don't work. No, this one does. Research terminal. This could be interesting. Section 1091-1092 report. The PAM initiative is already bearing fruit. Foreign operatives report that the corrective measures employed in the Taiwan Strait region have already greatly stabilized matters after the Pascal incident. The first few iterations of PAM's core code have increased the effectiveness of the program dramatically, but without drastic action, we're approaching a point of diminishing returns. The team asked for double the funding for the upcoming fiscal year. With additional cutting-edge databanks, we can boost the processing power of PAM threefold. Additionally, the PAM initiative needs to be fully tapped into all military and civilian agency intelligence apparatus. The combination of these two spends should give us a decided edge against the Chinese. And then also save transcripts. Let's try this one. 10 years before the bombs dropped. PAM, run the USSR-China attack scenario. Processing query. What goal does entity chairman seek in this hypothetical set of facts? Conquest. Run program. Your answer does not logically follow. An ideal nuclear first strike scenario would still leave 59% of the American nuclear stockpile free for retaliation. Pause it. You cannot conquer what is destroyed. PAM. Chairman Cheng isn't always logical. He won't always make logical decisions. We've been over this. Warning. Human variability results in a highly flawed statistical model. PAM, run the program. Warning. Warning. Emergency shutdown. Damn it, we've lost her. Power down. Did we get crash logs on that? Okay, and then 2 years before. Could you repeat for the general what you just told me? Pause it. Chinese stealth technology far outstrips our own capabilities. The Chinese intelligence apparatus is sufficient to conceal large-scale research operation from American operatives. Conclusion. The Chinese have a 91% chance of having conducted large-scale experimentation with stealth tech. Large-scale? What do you mean? What are their capabilities? American projects involving this technology, referred to Stealth Boy, have merely reverse-engineered, captured Hei Gui suits. The underlying science of this technology is unknown, so the theoretical limits are also unknown. However, the so-called ghost fleet that Station A-31 and B-19 reported in November may indicate that testing has already commenced with submersible vessels. Dear God, you think they have stealth subs? A second-order approximation is inconclusive. Explanation. The logic chain of these assumptions have required, or have too much variability. Further data is required. So you can't even give me a guess? Machine/human interface aborted. Sorry, sir, we're working on some of her glitches. Pam, well, she gets real stubborn when she's doing too much guesswork. Stubborn? She's a machine. Sir, with each new version, well, she's getting quirky. There's no way I'm taking this stealth sub nonsense to the Joint Chiefs unless I have proof. It's goddamn ludicrous to think the Chinese have been working on something this big and we've heard nothing. Virtually no actionable intelligence has come out of the Shaanxi province for 3.1 years. However, the province reports a spike in the imports of complex polymers and other key synthetic compounds. The quantity in question is consistent with stealth technology research on the macro scale. Until you give me something concrete, I don't want to hear another goddamn word about this. And then finally, in the year of, several months before, there it is, go ahead, unplug the cables, she's clear. What's the data integrity app? We can't tell until we boot her up. Initiating machine/human interface. Jesus, she's working, the numbers are looking good. Commencing analysis of this geographical point in space. She's actually in there, I can't believe we're doing this. After what she pulled off in July, I hear she may be sent over to the White House. Assessment complete. Greetings, Dr. May and Dr. Ramarijan. The interface is really coming along. When she runs it, have you seen how many cycles Malcolm is using for it? Pam, perform primary function. DEFCON is currently at 3. The odds of the alert state increasing this month are 12%. In order to increase global stability, a diverse set of detailed strategies must be adopted. I'll let the general know that Pam's mobile. Okay, so they were using this computer to do... It's kind of an informational thing, but they were also trying to figure out what, you know, the likelihood of the Chinese doing this or that or having this technology was, which is pretty interesting. And all of this is just extra stuff. You know, we've gone over this before. You don't have to check these terminals, but I tend to really enjoy the lore, and we'll try and find the lore whenever I can. So I enjoyed that. I thought that was cool. Nothing else really around here. Let's continue to move forward. As we get closer, we are going to alert the synths that are supposedly through the wall or whatever. It's probably some through this door. Department X, R&D.
Movement detected.
Yeah, movement detected in your head! Gotcha. Grit Jones! There's gonna be more. Let's move back a little bit. Kind of hard to hit because Hancock's in the way. Getting better. Laser Jones. Gotcha, you son of a gun. Go ahead and reload for a sec. All right, Deacon. You helping? Synth leader. I'm shooting the arms, but sure, whatever.
Stop right there.
Yeah, it was worth a shot. Is anyone else in here? No, the rest are upstairs. Leaded resin synth chest piece. Let's take a look at this stuff. That's not gonna be better than what I got. Lightweight nanofilament synth left leg. Strengthened resin synth right arm. You guys were telling me, I think, if I remember correctly, that the synth stuff does eventually become better than, what I'm using, the combat stuff. So is it left leg? I'm just gonna take a peek here. 19 to 19. 10 and 13, it's not going to increase that much. I think it has to be heavy. I don't know if they call it heavy or if they call it something else in the synth line. Where's that play? But they have, you know, their own version or whatever.
Open says me.
Oh, good job. Cool. Alright, what's in here?
So Tommy Whispers didn't make it out. He died protecting our secrets. Let me see. There. Tommy would want you to have his hand cannon. Don't let its size fool you.
I appreciate it.
May it serve you as well, heck, better than it did Tommy.
Deliverer. Improved VATS hit chance, 25% less action point cost. Okay, otherwise a pretty standard weapon.
Grab Carrington's prototype. You turn that over to Desdemona, and she'll have to let you into our merry band.
Alright. Doop a doop a doop boop. Anything of interest here? Nope. The prototype, which is over here
hostile
on the shelf.
Sensor reading detected.
There's still more synths in here.
Perfect.
Got the prototype.
The elevator's at the end.
Deacon.
Ah, the switchboard. a lot of
the sensitivity
memories.
Of my sensors clearly needs adjustment.
Did not mean to cut you off from saying whatever it was. I was trying to take this stealth boy. Were you saying something important?
I didn't think I'd ever see this place again.
All right, well, in post, I can pause when those subtitles were on screen and figure out what you said. The synth really wants some friends. I don't think these things do anything. I got a mini nuke out of this, which is pretty sweet. Doesn't seem to be anything else of interest in this room.
No enemy detected.
God, there's mannequins everywhere. All right, what's in here? Bottle cap mine. Hazmat suits, which I don't need any of. Gas masks. Nah. None of this is doing me any good. So did I see everything I needed to see? I can't access this. The medex finally wore off. I checked all of you guys. Was that, this room's empty, right? Like, it looks like there's a secret behind the wall or something, but I don't think there is. I think it's just where the vault was. Okay. We need to go up there, but before we do, I'm just gonna double check real quick that I did see everything I needed to see, because I felt like maybe I missed something over here. I did not technically walk this way. Maybe there was nothing over here. And I went down there, right? I believe, yeah, that was the first room I went in. Okay, just wanted to make sure, because this, I'm not 100% sure, but it seems like this is the type of place I won't be back to. So, I don't know if I'm right on that respect or not, but,
movement detected. Curious.
Oh, there's guys, like, right in here. Oh. How did I miss this? I must have went in a completely different direction. Son of a... Nice, Hancock! That's right, stab him. That's the best way. Okay, there's nothing in here. So, yeah, this was, I totally missed this area. So I'm glad that I took a minute to look around. Sometimes there's stuff hiding in the urinals or the toilets, but probably not this time. A boxing glove. Okay. Nothing there. There's some jet. Made Hancock proud with my drug use. I'm always trying to please those around me. Nothing in the mirrors. And there's a door here that we can pick. Go ahead and do that. Once again, fairly certain that we're not going to be back to the switchboard.
Nice.
Some stuff in here, and the stuff does not include synths, so I'm happy with that. Yes, no, what is this? Medical liquid nitrogen dispenser. It only gives you 2 steel, and it weighs 5, so no, that's a bit much. Okay. Got the things we needed here, went down this area. Then we walked in here. We went through here. Then we came through here. And we went through there. We went through there. So now it's time to go through here. And I think we may have actually killed everyone.
Hostile sensor reading detected.
We totally didn't kill everyone. I'm actually curious at this point if the synths even know how to open doors. They seem to do a very bad job of it over and over again. I got shot a split second before I got shot, or before I shot him, but that was fine. Oh, their heads come off just like human heads. Very cool. And also very dead. You are very, very dead. Let's open this security gate. Probably just a fusion core or something in it. Let's try to the right. Did I say right? I meant left. There we go. Got this thing open. So why did we come in here?
Institute gives its lackeys.
What?
Toys.
Gold watch, duct tape. What is that? Okay, there's a fusion core. It was just not how I expected it to be. Nothing down there. Beatrice Bell. I'm getting there, Deacon. I'm getting there. Am I not allowed to look around? Take some of this stuff? It's gas! How? That's the most bizarre thing. They should untick the box that says to question picking up that particular object. Power elevator, complete. Turret control. Apparently there's still one connected. But they were on our side, so it should be fine. It's not in here, is it? No, I don't see it. Alright. We good? They're gonna be waiting for us up there? I don't know. Quick save just in case. Come on, everybody. Onto the elevator. Or not, because you never do. Never get on this stupid thing. Cthulhor. Okay. So we did it. And those guys did not come with me. But we were just here last episode. So I think we're safe. I'm gonna walk out this door and hope for the best. Okay. Completed leave the switchboard. And then the next objective was meet Deacon. So where's Hancock? No idea. These are all the synths. Just kind of wondering if it would show that the other guy died. But I don't think so. Oh, wait. Is that Hancock coming out in the distance? I know I just saw him. I totally just saw him out there. Is that Deacon? I think that's Deacon. And there's Hancock, who teleported or something.
We got what we came for. Let's split up and meet back at the catacombs.
We made a good team.
The best. See you soon.
Okay. And that's that. All right, Hancock. I guess the next part of this mission is returning to the railroad. So let's do it. All right, we're finally back. It is a long walk because you have to teleport to the Old North Church and then you can walk in here.
And the new guy patched me up, put me on his shoulder, and blasted his way through the rest of the complex. Synths everywhere.
Carrying you the whole time?
Amazing, right?
That's one word for it. Deacon told me you single-handedly secured Carrington's prototype, disabled a minefield, and wiped out 100 Gen 1s. So is any of that true?
Every word he said was true, and then some.
A full 100. I can't even imagine.
See? Just like I said, boss.
I was expecting Deacon to grab a full team, including Glory, to secure that prototype. But instead, just the two of you cleared out the entire switchboard.
You'd be insane not to sign him up, Des.
You've certainly made an impression on Deacon. He's never spoken about, or lied about, anyone so highly before. Welcome to the railroad. Agent.
Why should I join you?
If you're having any doubts, you shouldn't. Not very many of us live to retirement. But if you're like me, that doesn't matter. There are great wrongs that need righting.
Glad to be aboard.
It seems we're very lucky to have you. So you're in. Now we need to know what to call you. Secrecy keeps us alive. Code names are a part of that. So what's yours?
Have any suggestions?
No. It doesn't work like that. Your life, your name, your choice.
Call me Charmer.
Charmer? Fitting. Your first official order is to deliver Dr. Carrington his prototype and see if he can use another pair of hands. But first, it's time to meet the rest of the gang. The location of our HQ is one of our most guarded secrets, so be careful coming in or out. You never can tell when you're being watched.
Woo! I did it! I beat one of them. And now I'm in with the railroad. So, I guess we get to finally go inside and see people. We've started Boston After Dark. Let's check out the HQ.
It may lack the amenities of the switchboard, but it's safe, and we've taken precautions not to be surprised again. Things are chaotic right now, so there's plenty for you to do.
Okay, lead the way. Don't let Hancock step in front of you, because then you'll just be stuck forever. This is a pretty interesting place down here.
Listen up, everyone. This is Charmer. He did the switchboard op with Deacon. He's a full agent, effective immediately. I'm counting on each of you to show him the ropes. Feel free to welcome him aboard. That is all. It's not an easy road you've chosen, but you're never alone in this.
Hmm. Okay. Should I keep following you? You got a few more things to show me? Or are you just gonna chill?
Desdemona.
Working with compartmentalized information is a difficult transition for new agents.
Hmm. Alright, I guess I'll show myself around and talk to a few folks.
Glad you signed on. Means I might get to take the occasional night off.
Alright, let's just, have a chat with everybody.
Got a lot of synths in play right now. Makes things really dangerous.
Hi.
Up there, assume you're being watched. Always.
So there are a few generic NPCs as well.
Desdemona told me to give you this.
I was asleep! Do you have any idea what time it is? Also, who are you?
An extraordinary feat to recover this, but that's hardly the point. Without a lick of training, and us knowing hardly anything about you, Des has invited you to join HQ. It would have been nice if she had consulted with her second in command. But what's done is done. Since you're here now, we might as well put you to work.
What, you don't think I can handle a dangerous job?
The danger doesn't concern me. Your work at the switchboard proves you can deal with that. I just hope the mission doesn't require knowledge about synths and our procedures. Something you've had scant opportunity to learn.
Cut to the chase.
One of our field agents, Old Man Stockton, needs help with a runaway synth. H-222. So headquarters, as always, puts out the fires that others can't be bothered to put out themselves. The paranoid old bat won't even tell us the problem. He insists that we get our intel from a dead drop.
What's a dead drop?
Tossing a body from a high ledge. Keep up.
Oh, dear lord. A dead drop is a mailbox with a rail sign on it. It's a common means of communication for us, so keep an eye out for them. When you make contact with Stockton, he won't give you the time of day unless you give him the proper countersign. The current sign is, do you have a Geiger counter? And the counter is, mine is in the shop. Please tell me Deacon taught you that at least.
You can trust me with this. I'll get it done.
You sound rather convincing, actually. Stockton is a prominent businessman at Bunker Hill. The dead drop will be near there. Use the escape tunnel in the back to get there quicker.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, Carrington.
I still can't believe Des assigned you to our HQ.
Is it really that unusual?
In my years of service, no one's ever just joined HQ straight away. True. You finding us in the first place was singular. But, put simply, you shouldn't be here. It isn't a question of competence, it's a simple matter of security.
And I'm going to compromise your security how?
Deacon's assurances aside, we don't know you, so your trustworthiness is up for discussion. Brushing that aside, before anyone joins HQ, they've usually spent years in the field. But you, you're dangerously ignorant of our procedures, our protocols. Since you're one of us now, might as well try to keep you alive. If you need patching up, see me.
What type of doctor are you?
My specialty is need to know and all that. However, I assure you I can treat any ailments or wounds you're likely to encounter. Word to the wise, be prepared to improvise. You may find your operational orders lacking.
You're obviously one of the smartest people here. What do you really mean by that?
No one doubts Desdemona is, inspirational. But let's just say strategy may not be her forte.
Is Desdemona really a problem then?
Not so much that, as there are perhaps better solutions. When planning a mission, a certain degree of clinical detachment can be invaluable.
Provided by someone like you.
As the third senior-most member of our organization, I do have the honor of participating in the planning of our missions. But my counsel is not always heeded. Focus on the objective, Everything else is just a distraction. Good luck.
Thanks, DC. You have a good snooze. All right, there's still quite a few people, I think, to talk with. Hi.
Solving for Theta N when I approaches probability bounds.
So you're Pam.
Pam.
Processing. Agent. Charmer. Your arrival was not calculated.
What do you mean it wasn't calculated?
Temporarily unable to process verbal input. Still processing. Preliminary adjustments to statistical models complete. Commencing introduction. I was, am, and will most likely be Pam. Predictive analytic machine.
Do you work for the railroad?
Yes. My goals and the railroad organization have a high degree of correlation. They provide data. I provide first-order approximations of the behaviors of all residents of the region, designated Commonwealth. Rephrasing, I predict the future.
You see the future?
That is this unit's primary goal. Caution. Biological life forms behave erratically, unpredictably. All output subject to an extremely high margin of error.
Just how inaccurate are you?
The smaller the group, and the greater the time frame, the less accurate I become. But all predictions are affected by the human element. Operation complete. You are a rogue variable. No current or previous models predict your presence or existence. Query, what is your point of origin?
I'm from Vault 111, if that's what you mean.
Accessing Vault 111. Cryo Vault. Believed destroyed. Conversation terminated. Pending construction of new probability matrix. Rephrasing. Goodbye.
Interesting. You have anything else to say, Pam?
Pam.
Commencing recurrence analysis using Dobrovian method.
I guess not. I think I broke her. Can I use this? Access records to entity designated Railroad Alpha and Token. I'm sorry, have a nice day. Latest prediction models. So I can use the terminal, but I can't, like, check anything.
Pam.
Analyzing.
You do a lot of analyzing. It was nice talking to you. Weren't you just behind me? Let's continue to walk around and see what we can see. Okay. What is in here? That's Glory. I got some other people in here. That's Deacon. Deacon, you want chat? I hate to wake everyone up, but also I'm gonna do it. You change clothes a lot. Holy crap. What's up?
Welcome to the family. We're a colorful and arguably insane bunch. But you're stuck with us now. Speaking of which, if you don't mind a sidekick, let's keep a good thing going and travel together some more.
Don't they need you here?
My job's mainly intel. So, the more places I go, the better I'm doing it. And you are just one big, beautiful distraction. Plenty of opportunities to learn secrets moving around in your shadow.
Not right now.
Not right now.
Well, if you change your mind.
Okay, so Deacon is available. Just a generic railroad agent. Railroad HQ escape tunnel, which I believe is where they actually want me to go. Let me double check my, retrieve the dead drop. Okay. So I gotta go find an escaped synth or runaway synth. Is there other people in here? Who are you? Just a railroad agent.
Hey, Rook. The name's Drummer Boy. It's my envious job to keep track of all the dead drops and grab incoming agents and tell them where they're needed. I don't suppose you want to switch places.
Why is that a bad job?
Runners at the bottom of the totem pole in the railroad. Just a hair above tourists. Being HQ's runner is a cut above field work, I suppose. Ah, someone's gotta do it. We'll be seeing each other. A lot.
Okay.
Hey there.
You from one of those vaults? You got too many teeth to be a scaver.
Let's see, that's the door we came in. There's another way we can... Oh, there's some more people. Tinker Tom.
Excuse me.
Sorry, I came at a bad time, but it's just kind of circumstantial. Hope you won't hold it against me. Can we chat?
The census sweep says you're clean. Hooray! We're bug free.
I went through a sensor sweep?
Every test Dez would let me run. Full EMF scan, biological sniffers, and other state-of-the-art security. So the sweep says the Institute isn't watching you, or us. But the tests lie, man. Okay, have you eaten anything out there? Because if you have, they got you.
Are you seriously asking if I eat food?
The food out there is dangerous. It's contaminated. That's why I grow my own food. Reclaimed pure water, local nutrients. Nothing goes in me that I don't see. That's how you stay safe. The Institute has these tiny microscopic robots in the food, man. And they report back.
Tom, that's rubbish.
You just don't get it, Carrington. The Institute is in your blood.
They're in my blood?
Absolutely not. Tom, we ran your tests extensively. We found red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets. Everything you'd expect.
And that doesn't get you the least bit suspicious. The results were too perfect. Too expected. And that's how they fool you.
There's no proof.
If we waited for proof for every Psycho Institute experiment, we'd all be worm food, man. Okay. If you really want to be safe, let me give you a little shot. Desdemona says no one has to, but it will kill those little robots.
There's battery acid in that serum of yours.
You can't nuke an omelet without irradiating some eggs. You ready to shoot up?
What's in the shot?
We've got algae, some yummy bacteria culture, and just a little bit of battery acid. But we gotta burn those babies out of you. It's a hard reboot of your system, man.
Seems questionable at best, Tom. Yeah, Hancock might like it.
Hit me, Tom.
Yeah, now you talking.
Oh, this is probably a bad... it's probably a bad idea.
Now you're encouraging him.
Hey, you get it, man. I make things around here. You go and do. You do whatever. And come back, and I will set you up.
What do you make?
All the custom toys you field agents use, my boys and I make. We're thinking outside the box, man. Gotta get real creative, real wacky to stay ahead of those Institute eggheads. Don't even get me started on all their secret projects. Now, I got all these ideas in my head. So building time.
I think you made me sick.
Hey.
You need anything?
What do you have in stock?
Well, it changes, depending on what's on hand. We lost everything when the switchboard went lights out. Hopefully our agents score more supplies in the field so me and my boys can, you know, make even more toys. You want to see what we got?
Show me what you got.
Take a look.
So what is it Tinker Tom sells before I hit the floor? Tinker Tom Special. If you're not yet in combat, increases VAT's accuracy but costs more AP. Various apparel. Visor. Okay. Yeah, my HP is, pretty low, Tom. Were you trying to kill me? Because, like, you nearly killed me. Let me look at my body. You broke my legs, Tom. There we go. That'll help a little bit. Jeez. Whatever that was. Another railroad agent. And then this is, I guess, just a shooting range of some sort. Also some little toys. Creepy. But why are there mannequins elsewhere if your shooting range is here? So many questions. Oh, this guy's got a terminal. I bet it's fantastic. Active Hypothesis, Nanoblood, Atmosphere / Baxter, Aliens Are Real, Our Own Bessie, Deacon / Time Travel Conjecture, Mutating Water Theory. If I really were a time traveler, would I let a timeline exist where you knew I knew? Disproved Theories. For now at least, Center of Earth Black Hole, 90% Synth Infiltration, Nuka-Cola Strawberry, Monty's Theory. Field Test Log. Spike's delivering enough kinetic energy to be well into the lethal range, but cooling unit keeps failing, melted 3 times. Treated Terry for first degree burns, got the reload time down with liquid nitrogen, delayed for Terry's hypothermia treatment. Up to velocity, can't find the spike. Getting close, I can feel it. Okay, interesting group of folks down here. Yeah, I'm gonna end it here. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. We are a little over time, but I figured I'd let it run long because, the only thing that really happened was that we finished the mission and then came back to this HQ, so I hope you'll forgive me for making it go a little long today. What do I do next? I know that, you know, I can't go too far with the railroad, or I'll be stuck in that path. Is the railroad one of those factions where it's like, hey, you will be locked out of all this other stuff? Because apparently, the Brotherhood of Steel are not. It's very... like, you, it doesn't really tell you, it just kind of happens. So I want to make sure that before I start doing some missions for the railroad, that things are going to be okay. You guys tell me what you want to see, and I'll get to it. Thanks for watching, see you next time for more Steven Plays Fallout 4. Can I jump up here? Only sort of.